Hello friends, my name is Dr. Puru Dhawan, and in this video we will talk about low potassium diet for a kidney failure patient. Low potassium diet is very important for kidney failure patient because if the potassium level increases above the normal range, it may cause multiple type of complications, especially with the heart, because potassium in a normal range helps the muscles to move, it gives power to muscles to move. But when the level of the potassium increases beyond its normal range, it causes fatigue. And because our heart is also made of muscles fiber, if the level of potassium increases, it may cause heart attack. So to keep potassium level in check, we have to work on the diet. And diet is the only thing which can control the level of potassium, because if the kidney is not performing well, what happens? Kidney body is unable to excrete out the waste material. As you are unable to waste material, whatever going is the inside is because of your diet. So if you control the diet, we can control the level of potassium inside our body. So let's start with the diet and see how the diet can affect our potassium levels. Every food item, whether it's vegetable, fruit, cereals, everything contains potassium either in high amount or low amount. So we have to select for those items which are low in potassium so that the level of potassium can be easily controlled. So let's start with vegetable and see what vegetables are low in potassium. Vegetables which are grown below the surface of earth, like potatoes, sweet potato, turnip, these vegetables are rich in potassium. So we have to avoid these vegetables which are grown below the surface of earth, except three: onion, carrot and radish. These are three vegetables which can be given to a kidney failure patient. Now let's move to another set of vegetable, and that are leafy vegetable. Leafy vegetable like spinach, mustard, coriander, mint has to be avoided for a kidney failure patient because they contains high amount of potassium in a natural way. So we have to avoid also these kind of vegetables. Now I know what are going in your mind. If you can't eat these kind of vegetable, we can't leafy vegetable, what kind of vegetable we can eat? So if a patient is suffering from kidney failure and the potassium level is high or about to high, we can go for low potassium vegetable. And to select these low vegetable is very easy. You can simply select the vegetable which are grown as a fruit on a plant or a creeper, round ground, bitter ground, snake ground, pumpkin, brinjal, tomato, ladyfinger. All these vegetables are low in potassium in a natural way. So if we select right type of vegetable, we can control the level of potassium in a kidney failure patient very easily. Now let's move towards the fruit and see how fruits can help us to control the level of potassium. If patient is diabetic, fruits are totally avoided. But if a patient is non-diabetic, fruits can be given to a kidney failure patient. But we have to take care of few things. We have to avoid few fruits like banana, kiwi, avocado, dry fruits and dates. These fruits contain a large amount of potassium, so we will avoid these fruits totally. Now the whatever rest fruits can be given, but the amount has to be limited. The portion size for a kidney failure patient will be 1 cup. Either we can take 1 apple, 1 pear, or 1 cup of papaya, 1 cup of muskmelon, or 1 cup of watermelon. So we have to take care of the portion size in case of kidney failure patient. Also we have to avoid all citrus fruit like mango, oranges, kinu, mosami, all the citrus fruit family, because if a kidney failure patient take a large amount of citrus fruit, what happen? Because of the citric acid present in the fruit, it may cause acidosis, metabolic acidosis. As the kidney is unable to filter out acid from the body, there is accumulation of acid in the body. Because of the accumulation of acid in the body, pH of the blood falls, and if we take citrus fruit like I told you earlier, this may cause further acidosis. So we have to avoid these, all this kind of fruit in a kidney failure patient. Now you know very well about the fruits, now you very well know about the vegetables, but we have to take these fruits and vegetable along with some kind of cereals. So in a kidney failure patient at Sai Sanjivani, we advise all kidney failure patient to go for any form of wheat. Wheat can be in the form of dalia, wheat can be in the form of suji, wheat can be in the form of maida. You can take any form of wheat, like you can take any form of rice. Rice can be taken as a boiled rice, it can be taken as a poha. So rice and wheat is a food which is contain potassium but in a low amount. So you can take any amount of wheat and rice in any form. Now in this video I will give you another way to look for potassium content in a vegetable. If you're looking for any vegetable which is grown in your place and you want to look for what kind of potassium content in it and whether kidney failure patient can take it or not, you have to do simply one thing. You have to look for its potassium content in Google search engine. So you will type the name of vegetable, like suppose you are looking for the potassium content of capsicum potassium content, and press the search button in Google. Whatever the amount come out, if the value of the potassium content is around 150 milligram per 100 gram. That means that vegetable is low in potassium. That means that vegetable can be given to a kidney failure patient. And if the level of potassium is very much high, above than 150, 160, 170, that means that vegetable has to be avoided in a kidney failure patient. There are few vegetables which can be given to a kidney failure patient after cooking. Suppose you have taken vegetable like cauliflower, which is high in potassium in a raw form, but when you boil that vegetable, when you leach that vegetable become edible for a kidney failure patient. So after cooking, after boiling, you can give that vegetable. So you have to take care of few things in a kidney failure patient. Never give raw food to a kidney failure patient. Never give juices to kidney failure patient. Never give any kind of puree, chutney, and any kind of concentrated form of any fruit or vegetable to a kidney failure patient. Because when the things become concentrated, when the things become condensed, amount of potassium also become condensed and they become higher in that product. So you have to avoid all these kind of things. There are few more things which has to be avoided in a kidney failure patient just to control the level of potassium. When the patient comes to the Sai Sanjivani, when we see the reports, sometimes we found that the level of potassium is very much high in a kidney failure patient where the level of creatinine is just 2 or 3. So we have to look for the causes of such high level of potassium. And generally what we find that the patient is taking some kind of low potassium, low sodium salt. Because every kidney failure patient suffers from high blood pressure. Just to control high blood pressure, we see advertisement of low sodium salts. And when the patient starts low sodium salt, what happens? The level of potassium starts increasing because that low sodium salt contains 15% of potassium chloride, and that 15% of potassium chloride causes elevation of potassium level in a kidney failure patient. So if you are suffering from kidney failure, your BP is high, never take any kind of low sodium salt just to control your blood pressure. Sometimes when a patient of kidney failure suffer from scanty of urine, what they do is they start taking some kind of coconut water, and when they take coconut water, the level of potassium suddenly increases. So we have to avoid coconut water also along with the low sodium salt. So with this video, you know very well about the vegetable, what kind of vegetable we have to take. This should be grown as a fruit on a plant or caper. You know about the fruits, what kind of fruits can be given, and about what amount of fruits can be given to a kidney failure patient. Now with this video, you know very well about the vegetables, what kind of vegetable can be given to a kidney failure patient. That vegetable should be grown as a fruit on a plant or a creeper. And you know about the fruit, the fruit size should be limited, the portion size should be 1 cup. And in case of cereals, you know the rice and the wheat are the two as such cereals which can be given in any form, in any quantity to a kidney failure patient. I think this is very much sufficient for our kidney failure patient to understand what kind of diet they should take just to control the level of potassium. Now there is another way that can help a kidney failure patient to control the level of potassium. To that we have to leach the vegetable, because whatever vegetable I told you earlier that contains potassium, they contain in low amount but they contain potassium. If your potassium level is above 5, we have to leach the vegetable so that the level of potassium can be bring further down. To that we have to chop those low potassium vegetable which I told you earlier and leach them for at least 15 to 20 minutes in hot water, or 1 hour to 2 hours in cold water, so that the potassium can be leached out in the water. And when we leach that kind of vegetable, what happens? The level of potassium decreases. And when we consume such vegetable which are leached properly leached, what happens? That amount of potassium goes lessen in our body, which results in lower level of potassium in your next KFT report. This process is very helpful for all kidney failure patients that are facing high level of potassium for unknown reasons. They can change their diet, they can change their vegetables, they can change their fruits, they can change their cereals so that the level of potassium can be easily controlled. If you have any question, query regarding anything regarding kidney failure or regarding low potassium diet, you can simply ask on the number given below. You can also visit our clinic and you can take an appointment and visit me on the same number given below. You can also visit our website saikidneyka.com for further information. With this, allow me to say goodbye. See you in the next video.